We are beginning the skeleton, and this is the first of two videos on the skull portion of the axial skeleton. As we go through these videos on the skeleton, something to keep in mind is to be able to distinguish between the bones of the axial skeleton compared to the bones of the appendicular skeleton, and be especially careful with the shoulder girdle and pelvic girdle because they're appendicular skeleton bones. There are 206 bones in the skeleton. However, 80 of them are part of the axial skeleton, and the axial skeleton is what you see in the lighter color in this image. It includes the skull, the vertebral column, and the thoracic cage. The skull consists of two subdivisions, cranial bones that enclose the brain, and facial bones, which make up the face. This video will start with the cranial bones of the skull. In this image, you can see how the skull is divided into the cranial bones that are encasing the brain and the facial bones, which make up the face. You need to know which bones are cranial bones and which bones are facial bones. So we're going to start with the 8 cranial bones. There's actually 6 terms here, but 2 bones are paired, one on the left, one on the right, which makes it 8. We have the frontal bone, the parietal bone, the occipital bone, temporal bone. You can see a little of the sphenoid bone, but we cannot see the ethmoid bone from this view. The frontal bone, mostly the forehead, think of it as the anterior portion of the cranium, and it contains a sinus, which is space inside of the flat bone. It also makes up the upper portions of the orbits. On this slide, we can see where the brain sits inside of the skull. And if we look at that area, which is made up of many bones, which we'll be going through, we can see that there's 3 distinct regions, actually called fossa, which are these basins inside the cranial cavity. You have an anterior cranial fossa, a middle cranial fossa, and a posterior cranial fossa. The parietal bone and its sutures, we'll see pictures of it on the next slide in this video. However, sutures are joints that connect cranial bones together. These are immovable joints once they fuse. However, there's some movement in them as an infant. So let's look at the parietal bone and the 4 sutures that exist. Here's the right parietal bone. There's one on the left as well. The suture that divides the 2 parietal bones is called the sagittal suture. The suture that divides the frontal bone from the parietal bone is the coronal suture. The suture that separates the parietal bone from the temporal bone is the squamous suture. And the suture that separates the parietal bone from the occipital bone is the lambdoid suture.